Hey everybody, this is Dr. Andrew Asadalahi, and in this video, we are going to be giving a quick overview of how to use Microsoft Excel and some of its basic features. So to get started, I am going to share my screen here. And from my screen, I'm going to open up Microsoft Excel. Now, it's usually best to open up Excel as the app on your computer. And not open it in SharePoint. When you open up Excel in SharePoint, it tends to deactivate some features. So I'm going to open up as the app on my computer, and I'm going to go to a blank workbook. Okay. And so when you're looking at Microsoft Excel, when you first open up this blank workbook, you know, it's a Microsoft product. So it has a lot of the same bells and whistles that you would see in Word or PowerPoint. So let's get started. Across the top, we have file, and file is where you can save things and find some other features. Most of the time, though, you're going to be operating in the home ribbon. We also have insert, draw, page layout, and several other features here. So let's just stay in the home ribbon here. We have the clipboard panel, we have the font panel, we have the alignment panel, number panel, so on and so forth. So so if you see the overall view in Excel, it's a spreadsheet program, okay? So that means that it's organized in terms of columns and rows. So across the top here, you see A, B, C, D. These are columns. So like this, for example, is column E. And then on the left, you see the rows. Rows are designated by numbers. So this is row 2, row 6, so on and so forth. Now, together, the rows and columns make cells. So, for example, here I have cell C6, and I can kind of zoom in on this if you want. Here is cell C4. This is E5, for example. Okay. Now, Excel is fantastic to use for calculations as well as just general organizational needs. Okay. So, let's play around with it, and let's look at it from an organizational perspective. Let's say you want to make a grocery list, okay? And so let's say that you type the word item, and then next to it, you can say price, and then I'm gonna say open parentheses and put a dollar sign, okay? And let's say you want to go grocery shopping, and you want to shop for apples and milk, and let's say you want some chicken, okay? And so here you can add up, you know, collect and add up the prices. I'm just making up numbers here, but let's say some apples are going to be $3.99. Let's say milk is $2.99, and let's say chicken is $5.79. Okay. And let's say you want to add all these up. So I'm in cell D8 right now, just for reference. Anytime you start a calculation in Excel, you always start with an equal sign. So if I want to add these up, I can manually click these three numbers and hit a plus sign in between each of the three of them. And by doing that, what's the last one? D7. By doing that, that manually adds these values up. That's fine. Some of you may know of some of the Excel built-in functions, right? One built-in function is the sum function. So I can start with an equal sign, type SUM. Open parentheses, and then I can highlight the cells that I want to add their contents together, and I get the same thing, 1277. Let's say you want to add in tax. Let's say that tax is 9.25%. Then here you can say equals this previous cell D8, 1277, times 1.0925. That will incorporate in a factor of 9.25% as tax, for example. So you can hit enter there. And so we could call this subtotal, and then we could call this total with tax, okay? And you can even put a little equal sign here just to indicate, you know, the subtotal is 1277 and the total is 1395. Now, you know, In engineering and science, we keep track of decimal places and sig figs. So, for example, it doesn't really make sense to show a total cost with how many sig figs. Is it 6 significant digits or 4 decimal places? So let's say you want to decrease that number of decimal places. Well, Up here under number, you have these two options where you can increase decimals or decrease them, as we would want to do here to 1395, okay? We can also format this a lot nicer than it looks now. So you can highlight this, and you can, under the font panel, you can add all borders here. And if you want to have a thicker outside border, you can have that selection, that option two, thick outside borders. You can center under alignment. You can center these, the item and price labels. You can left justify numbers here if you'd like. There's all kinds of formatting things you can do here just to make your table look nicer or make anything in Excel look nicer. You can highlight these cells. Let's say you want to highlight them blue just to give it a little bit of color there. Let's say you want to make these column labels bold, so I can bold the item and the price labels as well. You can expand cells and make cells look wider or more narrow. So all kinds of little formatting things. Of course, you can, if you want to change the font, you can Control A, which means select all. And of course, the default font, as you can see, is Calibri 11-point font. Let's say we want Times New Roman 12-point font. So we can do that as well. Now, while we're here, one thing I want to point out is printing. You know, often we like to print things from Excel. So if you're not careful, you know, you're not going to be able to see where the print borders are. How do you know where this table is on a page that's going to be printed? Well, a quick way you can do that, if you go to File and then Print, you can look at a print preview, and that'll show you where that table is on a piece of paper that's going to be printed if the default's 8.5 by 11-inch paper. And as you can see, that's the letter right here, default. If I hit the back button, what I've now done is I've introduced these little dashed lines. Now, it may be hard for you to see, but on my screen, this dashed line is between column J and column K. You see these little faint dashed lines here? That is the physical border of the page that's going to be printed. So as long as those are present and you can visibly see them, that can help you determine where you should be copying and pasting or placing tables. And so that brings me to my next thing. You can copy and paste things pretty easily in Excel. I can grab this table. I can hit Control X, which is cut, and I can move somewhere else and hit Control V, which is paste. And that'll just move things around as needed, okay? You can have multiple sheets, or sometimes called tabs, open in Excel as well. So if you take a look down here at the bottom of the screen, we have something called sheet one. If you hit this plus sign, that opens up a sheet two. Now don't panic, everything you did in sheet one is still there. You just click that sheet one and you're back to where you started before. This is what's neat about this is you can have multiple sheets. You know, I can click a couple more if I want, and all of these sheets are part of the same Excel file. So later, if I hit File up here and I save as somewhere, then all of these sheets will be saved, together because it's one file. And another cool thing is that you can link these sheets together. So these sheets, you can cross-reference them. So for example, in way over here in sheet four that I created, if I want cell D9 to report the value from something in sheet one, let's say I want sheet four to read the price of milk for some reason, that's all the way back in sheet one, I can just link that. And you see in sheet four, if I double click this, it says equals the value from sheet one in cell D15. So again, very powerful tool here for computations. So this would be a good time to maybe stop this video and take it upon yourself to take a few minutes and play around with Excel and become familiar with some of these basic attributes. And then we can create another video and go through another video example of some more of the bells and whistles in Excel. So with that said, we're gonna wrap up this video here. Thanks for watching.